Hello guys, and welcome back to this new video. So today we are going to talk about, in a short video, of the surprising and extraordinary skills of Incas surgeons. Okay, so basically there was a study that deserves here to be mentioned, and that study was conducted by two bioarchaeologists. One is John Verano and the other one is and Tidobam, and also by a neurologist David Kushner, all of them from the University of Miami. They have analyzed the superior skills of Incas surgeons, specifically in drilling skulls. Okay, so let's walk a step back. Drilling is something that was well known, drilling the skulls of course, was well known since the ancient Greeks, because we do have sources that report and testify that. We do have sources of ancient Greeks talking about relieving the pressure on the head, on the skull, and so drilling the skull. But we're talking about Peru, and we're talking about way earlier than the ancient Greeks. So this is like a set of knowledge that was well known in a different part of the world way before the rational ancient Greeks. And specifically in Peru, due to the conditions of the weather, of the climate, those remains have preserved quite well. So the researchers in question have analyzed three different sets of skulls. One is made of 59 skulls that can be traced back to 400 to 200 before Christ. The second group is 421 remains of a much later period, between 1000 and 1400s after Christ. And then the third one of 160 remains of skulls, specifically derived from the Cusco Altopian, that were traced back to 1400s to 1500s after Christ. What they have measured in a very simple manner, basically they have seen whether the perimeter, the surface is smooth or not, because smoothness of the surface and kind of like the hole repairing itself immediately would mean somehow that those people actually survived, whereas irregularities around the skulls would probably mean that those people actually died after their skulls being drilled. And what they have found is that 40% of the first group actually survived, which is not a great percentage overall, but then the percentage increases dramatically to 53% of the second group and 83% of the third group, which means that probably the set of knowledge, also we might need to think about hygiene that might cause a lot of infections, the set of knowledge in drilling a people's skull of those surgeons was actually amazing. 83% is an astounding percentage. And we also know that specifically of a group of 9 skulls in northern Altopians, that percentage would get to something like 91%, which is like amazing. Now, the holes were incredibly small, and those percentages were also way above the percentages of Civil War, American Civil War, where the data show that only something between 46 and 56% of people actually survived being drilled or having their skulls being drilled. Now, of course, we also need to mention here that the traumas of people from the Inca civilizations might have been, and should have been, to be honest, way different from modern traumas, right? And traumas of the war, where you had way heavier equipment and weapons, so it was way more easy to get hurt, but also way more difficult to be healed and be cured by surgeons. But the fact that, first of all, we have this data, it's just amazing. I mean, the Incas were a civilization that was often underestimated just because they didn't have a proper writing system, or because they didn't invent wheels, or because simply the Western tradition has interpreted the ancient Greeks as the creed of humanity in terms of rationality. But we actually know nowadays a lot of things. We do know that probably ancient Egyptians knew way more ancient Greeks, you know, and so the set of knowledge that those people had at the time was just absurdly amazing considering the situation. And that also sheds light on the fact that we have adopted certain Western-centric sort of lens through which we have interpreted history and ancient history. Now, guys, though, now, with that being said, that is it. So I just want to know what you guys think, and if you knew about this, I just find it amazing. And we'll talk some more in a new different episode about something else, most likely. So if you have enjoyed the video, don't forget to like it and subscribe to the channel. And if you want to comment below, please go ahead and comment below, let us know your thoughts, and we'll talk some more next time. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you can receive any updates. So we'll talk next time. Bye.